Welcome to another Amadeus video tutorial. In this session, we'll guide you through the process of manually creating and updating a transitional stored ticket, or TST. There are situations where you may need to manually create a TST. For example, during a ticket reissue, or when the fare is not available in the system but the airline has authorized ticket issuance. This process is typically based on an agreement between the airline and the end user. However, since it is handled manually, Amadeus does not guarantee it in case an agency debit memo is raised by the airline. Let's begin the process of creating a manual transitional stored ticket. To start, use the TTC transaction. After that, type a slash followed by the letter S to indicate the segment. Then enter 2-5 to specify segments 2 through 5 of the PNR. Next, add another slash followed by the letter P, representing the passenger, and the number 1 to indicate passenger 1. Once you've entered the command, press the Enter key to create the manual TST. The system has now generated a manual TST and updated all the required air segments of the PNR with their respective statuses. The origin and destination are automatically updated based on the selected PNR segments. In the TST display, you'll notice the office ID, the two-letter sign-in code, the date of creation, and the TST fail code M1, which indicates that the TST was either manually created or modified. To update or insert information into the TST record, use the TTK transaction, followed by a slash and the letter T with a number 1, indicating TST record number 1. Next, add another slash, followed by the letter B, which indicates the fare base identifier. Enter the desired fare base. Then press Enter. As a result, all TST lines reflecting the specified fare base. Next, use the TTK transaction once again, followed by a slash and the letter T with a number 1, which refers to TST record number 1. Next, add another slash followed by the letter A, which represents the baggage allowance identifier. Then, enter the required baggage allowance. Press Enter to proceed. All TST lines reflecting the specified baggage allowance. Next, use the TTK transaction again, followed by a slash and the letter T with a number 1, indicating TST record number 1. Then, add another slash, followed by the letter L and 1-2 to specify lines 1 through 2 of the TST. After that, include another slash, the letter V for the validity identifier, followed by the not valid before date and the not valid after date. Press Enter to proceed. Lines 1 and 2 of the TST are now updated with the specified validity dates. Next, enter the TTK transaction once again, followed by a slash and the letter T with a number 1, indicating TST record number 1. Then, add another slash, followed by the letter L and the range 3-4 to specify lines 3 through 4 of the TST. Next, include another slash, the letter V for the validity identifier, followed by the not valid before date and the not valid after date. Press Enter to update TST record. Lines 3 and 4 of the TST are now successfully updated with the specified validity dates. Next, enter the TTK transaction once again, followed by a slash and the letter T with a number 1, indicating TST record number 1. Then, add another slash followed by the letter F. This is the base fare identifier, followed by $208, where USD is the currency code for US dollars and 208 is the base fare amount. Next, add another slash and the letter E, which stands for the equivalent fare amount. Enter ETB 26,310.00, where ETB is the currency code for Ethiopian Birr and the amount is 26,310. Finally, add another slash, followed by K1. The identifier for the bank selling rate and enter 126.4888. Press Enter to update the TST record. The base fare, equivalent amount, and bank selling rate are now successfully updated in the TST. Next, enter the TTK transaction once again, followed by a slash and the letter T with a number 1, indicating TST record number 1. Then, add another slash followed by the letter X, which is used to identify a new tax. Enter the tax amount. For example, 18,974, followed by the corresponding tax code, such as YR. Continue entering all required tax amounts along with their respective tax codes. Once all taxes have been entered, press Enter to update the TST. All the specified taxes are now successfully updated in the TST record. Next, enter the TTK transaction once again, followed by a slash and the letter T with the number 1, which refers to TST record number 1. Then, add another slash followed by the letter L, which is the line identifier. Enter 2X, where 2 refers to line number 2 of the TST, and X indicates a no stopover. Next, add a comma, followed by 4X, where 4 is line number 4 of the TST, and again, X denotes no stopover. Press Enter to apply the changes. Lines 2 and 4 are now successfully updated with a no stopover indicator in the TST. Next, enter the TTK transaction once again, followed by a slash and the letter T with the number 1, which refers to TST record number 1. Then, add another slash followed by the letter C, which is used to enter the fare calculation line. When entering the fare calculation, remember this important rule. A space is required between alphabet to alphabet or numeric to numeric. However, no space is needed between alphabet and numeric or numeric and alphabet. Once you've entered the nukes and the ROE, press Enter to update the fare calculation in the TST. The fare calculation is now successfully updated in the TST. Pro tip: you can easily copy the fare calculation line from the FQP command result for your required fare base and paste it after the letter C. Save the update information in the TST. Before issuing a ticket, it's important to update both the mandatory and optional ticketing elements. To update the form of payment, use the FP transaction, followed by INV to indicate invoice as the payment type. Press Enter to proceed. To enter the commission, use the FM transaction followed by 0, indicating 0 commission. Press Enter to update. To set the validating carrier, use the FV transaction followed by SV, the airline code for Saudi Airlines. Press Enter to apply. To add the endorsement, use the FE transaction followed by the free flow text as advised by the airline. Then, press Enter. These updates ensure all ticketing details are correctly set before issuing the ticket. Save the ticketing elements in the PNR to issue ticket. It is highly recommended to pre-validate the ticket before final issuance to ensure all details are correct. To do this, use the TTP transaction, followed by slash T1 to indicate TST record number 1, slash TKT to request pre-validation without issuing the ticket, and slash RT to keep the PNR active. Press Enter to proceed. If the system responds with OKTO ticket, it means that all required information has been correctly updated in both the TST and the PNR, and the ticket is ready to be issued. To issue the ticket, use the TTP transaction, followed by slash T1 to indicate TST record number 1, and then slash RT to keep the PNR active after ticket issuance. Press Enter to proceed. When the system responds with OK etiquette will issue, it confirms that the ticket has been successfully issued. To view the issued ticket from the PNR, use the TWD transaction to display the e-ticket record. Then, add a slash followed by the letter L, which is the line identifier, and 9 to specify line number 9 of the FA element in the PNR. Press Enter to proceed. This will display the details of the issued e-ticket associated with the selected FA line. To display taxes for issued e-ticket, use TWD slash tax transaction. Press Enter. Here are the taxes for issued e-ticket. To display the current displayed e-ticket record, use TWDRT transaction. Press Enter to proceed. Here is e-ticket record details. If you need to switch from displayed e-ticket record to issued e-ticket active PNR, use RT asterisk and letter E. Press Enter to proceed. Here is active PNR for issued e-ticket. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative videos.